me read from this report. It says, on July 13th, two juveniles were in a fatal traffic accident on the 400 block of Kansas Avenue. Shortly after the crash, several citizens came to aid the two injured juveniles. The defendant, Paul Pelton, recorded the aftermath of the crash on an electronic device. Mr. Pelton then posted the video on a public Facebook page. The video shows both juveniles in the front seats of the vehicle. The decedent, Cameron Friend, is observed seated in the passenger seat, leaning towards the driver's seat. Both juveniles appear to be bleeding, and the decedent's breathing is labored. Pelton opens the rear passenger door and puts the electronic recording device inside the vehicle. Pelton then records the front seat's occupants. A woman says, "Put the light down so that no one goes into shock." So Pelton walks around to the front of the vehicle, returns to the passenger side, where he puts his device into the vehicle again. As the police arrive, Pelton walks away down Kansas Avenue, but returns to the vehicle as occupants are being removed, and then continues recording.
I'm very sorry for my conduct on July 13th and my actions after the car accident. I accept responsibility for my behavior. I understand that I should have made better choices. The events of July 13th were a tragedy. It was never my intention to contribute in any way to the heartache of so many. I've learned a lot from this experience.
Now, I'm being asked to treat this like some simple trespass case, like somebody walked in my yard to pick up their Frisbee, and I should treat it like it's some simple trespass case, but it's not. It's well beyond that. I mean, instead of offering these two individuals some help, if not help, at least some comfort, what I have is somebody trying to profit off it. Make a gory video, try to sell it on the internet, then try to intimidate the other juvenile to change his story. I mean, totally outrageous behavior. And I wouldn't be doing my job if I just let it go with some type of order of probation. I mean, I feel somewhat dismayed that the maximum sentence I can impose is 30 days in jail, because I think that the actions probably deserve more. But obviously, I'm confined to keep my ruling, obviously, within the confines of the law. In any event, it will be the judgment of law and the sentence of this court that you be sentenced to a fine of $250 and 30 days in jail. That's on case number 2015, CRB 03917. And on case number 2015, CRB 02372, that's a disorderly conduct count, 30 days in jail, concurrent to the other case. Anything further from anyone? Thank you, Mr. Paul. You can go with the officer right away.